about right that Emily's gone.
You want to hear the truth? I don't know whether I can bear this loss. I can hardly breathe.
My grandmother, sit down.
No, it won't help. You see, Emily graced us with so much strength and beauty. She was a light around which all of us could revolve.
I know.
And to have her so suddenly and so brutally ripped away, well, it's broken something inside me that I don't think will ever mend.
It's your heart.
Hi, Ned.
Monica.
My, it seems we only see you at holidays and funerals. You get a double feature this time.
Emily's funeral is on Wednesday, Ned. I hope you can stay.
Yeah, of course. I cleared my calendar.
And that's exactly what I should have done. Cleared my calendar. I mean, this was a celebration for Alan and the endowment that Nicholas did for him. I should have insisted that Julian do that surgery for me, but no, I had to do it myself.
Hey, I came as soon as I could.
Good to see you home, son.
Monica. I loved Emily. Not because she was family. She was a good and generous human being.
I know. And she left you too, and I'm really glad that you are here, and I'd really like to say something that would be meaningful right now, but I really don't have it in me. Because I can't get past the fact that I missed the last few hours of my daughter's life. I mean, the time that we could have spent together. Maybe it would have made a difference.
Emily's death was a random occurrence. A madman crashed a party and went on a rampage.
No, excuse me, Ned. There was nothing random about it. Anthony Zakara is a known gangster and he kills for a living. Just like my son does. Isn't that ironic? All these years I have been defending Jason's choices, and it was his choices that killed my daughter. There's nothing you can say, Bobby.
Oh, I know. I was thinking maybe you're the one who needs to talk. I do have painful experience to draw from.
Yeah, so do I. I'm still trying to get used to that word, widow. You know, I really hate it. Emily came to us just a little girl who lost her mother to a disease that was about to take me. And she gave me the will to live. She was the most precious gift I'd ever had, Bobby. And now she's gone. Brutally. Senselessly, and I am hurt and I am sad, but I can't feel all of those emotions right now because the one thing that is stuck in my heart right now is incredible anger.
No, you won't believe this now. Because I didn't when BJ's death was still so fresh and raw, but one day, when you least expect it, you're gonna think about the daughter you lost, and all you will feel is love and gratitude. And she came into your life.
Ah, Nicholas. Emily gave this to me on Mother's Day, and I haven't worn it, but today I couldn't think of wearing anything else.
Listen, I just wanted to say, well, so many things to you. And first off, I know you know I loved your daughter very much. And thank you. Just thank you for raising such an amazing woman. And I want you to know that she loved and respected you very much. And I'm so sorry. I'm sorry. I'm just sorry. You know, I would have done anything for her. Including die for her. I keep racking my brain, trying to think of how I could have prevented it somehow.
No, Nicholas, don't. You had nothing to do with it. In fact, you were responsible for the joyous times in Emily's life.
I asked her to marry me. For the ball. Said yes. Yeah. So, I'm gonna go.
Wait a minute. I just want to tell you that I will be eternally grateful for you loving Emily and for knowing what an extraordinary woman she was. Loving her the way she deserved to be loved. I keep thinking that this is just a nightmare that we're going to wake up, but it's not going to happen. We've lost her. And all we can do is figure out a way to go on. Q? You have a visitor. Oh, Alice, please send them away. I'm not in the mood for any... Hi.
I know this is a terrible time to show up unannounced. And you can tell me to go if you want. But this has been such a year of unrelenting loss, and some of us are feeling a little alone and orphaned, and... Do you know any place to go?
But I'm sorry. No, Sky, please. We were just about to sit down and have a traditional Thanksgiving pizza. We'd love it if you would. Lila Ray would join us.
Broken lights on the freeway left me you alone. I may have lost my way now, haven't forgotten my way home. I'm falling apart.